And there's no lights in here. Because his brother was pretty frugal.
Oh, yeah.
Feast your eyes. Most of these cars are for sale. Is the giant ant for sale?
Yes.
And then up in the rafters, there's a whole lot of bikes.
This Kaiser, by the way, Jim, was a four-door sedan.
Okay, now we're going to start. We're not going to take a break, so we're going to start and get right into it. This is a car that's for sale. And this is a what? What year Kaiser?
I think it's a 51. And I was telling Jim that this started out as a four-door sedan, and somebody cut the top off and filled in the back seat area. The car was built out in Kansas somewhere. Don't know for sure when.
And you don't know when that was done?
No. But they made a two-seater out of it, so it's kind of like a sports car.
Okay. And this is one of the cars that's for sale.
And it is a run-and-driving car.
Run-and-driving car. Probably has a title.
Yep.
Let's go on to this next one here.
Okay, that is a 26 Model T Roadster pickup that I believe Jack bought that in Colorado. And it's kind of got the rat rod theme to it, but that wasn't really the intention. It's just the way it was when he bought it. But it is a running driving car.
And this one's for sale.
Yep. That is a 30 Model A panel that was a restored truck. Jack kind of hot-rodded it a little bit.
Then Jack did the work himself. He did most of the work on all these cars himself when they needed it.
And it is an excellent, excellent running vehicle.
And this one's for sale.
Yep.
Now, this is a car that I remember. This came from Hawaii, if you can believe that.
Yeah, that is a Model A, a 30 Model A Phaeton.
So this is a Phaeton that's been rotted. You don't know when the work was done, right?
I don't, but I don't really think it was that long ago. I think it was just somebody that had the mindset that they wanted it to appear as an old hot rod, you know.
Is that your brother's hat and overall?
Oh, yeah.
And let's look here, because this says Haunted Gulch.
Haunted Gulch. And I put that on there for him. So he wanted it to look like a vehicle from an old dude ranch, you know.
Okay. Now this is the one that's staying in the family.
Yes.
Your sister. Jumpin' Jack.
Flying
Flashes, Circus. Flying Circus. And that's a reference to your brother, right?
Right. Yep. And I also did that sign on there for him.
So. You did the sign. Beautiful job. And what year is that?
That is a 36 Ford panel truck.
What a beautiful car.
Jack built that as a hot rod in about 1969.
This, folks, is my favorite. This is actual lettering. This isn't like a tribute car. This is the actual lettering. This came out of what, Kansas?
Missouri.
Missouri?
Roseville, Missouri.
And Roseville, Missouri.
The way I understand it, when they put the box on the back, then that qualified as a service vehicle.
Right.
So when the gas rationing stuff was going on, they could buy gas. They could get more gas than if it were just a passenger car. And actually, you know.
You even got a lunchbox in there.
They chopped up a pretty nice car. But it is what it is, you know.
Got some toolboxes here on the side. And then this is also one that's staying in the family.
Yep.
Your sister likes this one too. And what do we got here?
This is a 1930 Model A Roadster pickup. Has a small block Chevy and an automatic transmission. And just absolutely really raspy, nasty cam.
And what year is this right here again?
This is 31.
Okay, and this car here, well, I lied. This is probably my favorite car here. This one's also for sale, right?
Right.
This is probably, would you say the most valuable car in here?
No. A couple of them that are more valuable than this are down in Spencer.
Okay, we may get a chance to look at Spencer, but tell us about this car.
It's a 40 Ford coupe that we, as far as we know, it originated in like West Virginia or Virginia, I believe. Has a flathead, later model flathead with a couple of Stromberg carburetors on it. All stock original interior. And I see somebody has chromed the window moldings and that kind of stuff, but it's an excellent car.
And who did this belong to?
Belonged to Dave Wells of the Wells Blue Bunny Ice Cream Factory. And these bumpers, Jim, I don't know if you noticed or not, but those bumpers are off of 49 Plymouth with that rippled, and they fit on there like they belong there. You know, they look really good on them.
And this car is for sale?
Yes.
And then we've got over here,
that is a 28 or 29 Model A Woody wagon.
And that's for sale?
Yep.
And then you told me about this one.
Well,
this has had a lot of work.
This is one that Jack bought body only, and then he had to re-chop it because somebody did a horrible job of chopping the top.
So this is an example of Jack's work.
And then he also channeled the body down over the frame, so he unchanneled it, and they sectioned the body 5 inches, and he unsectioned it, and then put it all back together. So it's got a massive amount of work in it.
This is a running and driving car.
Yes, that's got a 350 Chevy hooked to the stock Ford transmission.
And what do we got here?
This is a 34 Ford three-window coupe that came out of Mount Vernon, Washington. It was featured in a magazine called Rodder's Journal. It was on the cover, and it also did a follow-up story to it on the inside. It has a 454 big block Chevy, a 400 turbo transmission, interior. I mean, it pretty much is a finished car.
Can't go wrong with black.
Upholstery and stuff. Yeah, exactly.
With the white piping. That's a pretty car. And your number for people to call if they have a serious interest in buying any of these cars that they see, other than the ones that are noted to be sold, or any of the bikes that you see up in the rafters. And there's other stuff in the rafters too. There's some other knickknacks up there.
And my number is
712-240-3334. Okay.